Hi my loves, how's it going? How you guys doing? Welcome back to another Beauty Empties. Now, I have a decent amount of products this month. It's nowhere near what I had for the last 3 months or even close to it. However, that being said, there is still a massive chunk of empties that are here. I have got to a point where almost every item that I'm currently using is brand new in the sense of I've just opened it or replaced an item that I've like used. So it's going to take me quite some time to have like a massive pile of empties like I was having before. However, I still have got a decent amount of empties, and as always, I'm really happy if I have any makeup empties at all. So let's dive right into today's video. Okay, so the first thing I want to talk about is this Anovia coconut water shampoo. It looks really grimy because I took it out of my shower and put it straight into this box. I did not like this. I think, or at least I felt like anytime I used it, this would make my hair like really oily almost straight away. So what I decided to do was just start using this as like a first cleanse shampoo and then go in with like a second cleanse shampoo. That's the way that I feel like my hair feels the cleanest and is actually the cleanest. The first round kind of takes out some of the oil and the second round actually cleans my hair properly. Where I have like a dry scalp and it's sort of flaky, I feel like I really do need to make sure that I do that. But whenever I used to use this, it just made my hair really oily. So that's the way I had to use this up. I personally would not buy this again. I think initially my brother bought this for himself. He didn't like it, gave it to my mom. She didn't like it. So I thought, okay, rather than me using up my really, really expensive shampoos by double cleansing, I might as well use this one up. And I'm glad that this is done and out of the bathroom. Another empties I have is this packet of wax melts. So these are from Miley. These are the wax that you do yourself for your own body. And I have to say, to the people who wax themselves, genuinely, I know the struggles. If you don't wax yourself and you get wax from outside, yes, it's painful, but at least you don't go through the pain of actually having to wax yourself. I wax my underarms and down there, and genuinely, it takes me 2+ hours to do that. By the end of it, I'm lightheaded, dizzy, ready to like pass out. It's an intense sport. Like, it really is difficult. I've used up one of these and I think I didn't actually like this one as much. I feel like with this wax, it was a little bit more difficult for me to sort of get used to it. But also I feel like this caused me more pain. They have another one, and it's the white one, and I don't remember what that one is, but I have used that one up in the past and I think I will purchase that one. I've just decided to home wax for the time being because it's more convenient, and also it works out sort of cheaper. I will eventually probably start doing like full body waxes from outside, but it's just right now this is all I can sort of manage. That's what I'm doing it. But honestly, it's an extreme sport. Like, I did it the other day and I was ready to just pass out because it was intense. I literally used up this sheet mask a couple days ago. I've had this in my collection for some time and it was really time for me to use this up, only because one, it was a really easy empty, and the other one is because I don't exactly remember when I bought this. So it could have been close to a year or like longer than that. This is from Boots. It's the Botanics Vitamin C Glow Sheet Mask. I actually really like this. It was quite a nice mask to use. It didn't actually come with as much serum as the Garnier ones do, but I did like this. I know that these sheet masks are not necessarily recommended because it causes like a waste to the environment. I can't lie, I do like to sometimes indulge in these, but it'll be sort of like a very rare scenario. It is nice to use. I actually did like this. Would I buy these again? I don't really know. I'm currently trying to avoid buying as much as possible, especially when it comes to skincare and hair care. I'm just trying to literally use everything up that I can. But this is a nice product. I have one more of these left. I think the last one I've got is an aloe vera one. So let's see when I sort of schedule in my next proper self-care day. The next product is from Avene. It's supposed to be a thermal spring water. Basically, this is just expensive water. This does nothing. It didn't really feel hydrating. I used a spray on my face and it used to disappear instantly. I thought this would give me sort of like, it would at least last on my skin for a little bit for me to put on my toner or something else so that it sort of like seeps into my skin together. No, it doesn't. It's just expensive water. I might as well have gotten a spray bottle myself, put in water from the tap and sprayed that, because this did nothing. It literally is expensive water. A product I absolutely hated and would never recommend with my whole heart is this one from Rituals. This is the Invisible Sun Protection 50 plus SPF. This is a chemical SPF. And if you use chemical SPFs, you know that these tend, if they get into your eyes, they sting like a mother. These are horrible. when they get into your eye. And if you're driving and these get into your eye, you're kind of screwed, okay? This happened to me a couple of times. Aside from it being a complete danger and hazard, another reason I didn't like this was because whenever I used to put this sunscreen on and do my makeup, whether I had the sunscreen on for an hour, half an hour, 20 minutes, or longer than that, it would always peel for whatever reason, which was really frustrating because sometimes you're in a rush and you don't have the time to like redo your base, and it was really frustrating when that would happen. Most of the times I was just at home, so it was whatever, but still it was quite inconvenient. And another reason I didn't like this is because if you use this expired, you're gonna have crazy breakouts. I didn't realize that the last 2 to 3 times I used this sunscreen had expired on me. And by the time I then got around to using it and I realized it was just breaking out, I had breakouts everywhere, all over my nose, my forehead, my chin, and my cheeks. I still have some breakouts left over, even though it's been like a week and a bit since I've stopped using this product. Actually, no, it's been longer than that. I think I disregarded this product around like the 20th, so about a week and a half, 2 weeks. But yeah, I really don't recommend this. There's a few sunscreens that I liked and I've enjoyed. Most of the sunscreens I feel like I've used, I've just always been so disappointing. This is definitely top 3 of the most disappointing ones I have used. This is the Superdrug Trichology Soothing Scalp Serum with caffeine, lime and ginseng. This is supposed to reduce the appearance of dandruff and improve scalp comfort. So I've got like a specific area where I've got really sort of like dry patch of skin, and it's really annoying, and I don't know what to do to sort of help that issue, because it's not psoriasis, it's something else, and it's really frustrating, and I can't even seem to get an appointment at the doctor, so that's great. Whenever I used to use this product on my scalp where it's itchy, it really did help with soothing the skin and making it not itchy, and make it like, sometimes the itchiness can be so intense that if I don't use this, I will be like scratching my scalp really badly. So for that reason, I have to make sure that I shower and wash my hair or scalp every other day. But also this in between washes, it has been like a literal lifesaver. Also for the last like 3 weeks, I've had like biab nails done. So these are nowhere near as sharp as my natural nails. That's also sort of helped. But yeah, this product though, if you are struggling, is a really good one to use in between washes. Would really recommend. I'm on my next bottle and I will probably pick up like another 3 of these because they were that good. Another ritual product is the 2-in-1 hair and body wash. This is their sports sort of collection. I bought a summer advent calendar from the brand, I think back in 2022. I don't think it was last year, but I feel like it was the year before in 2022. It just had like a bunch of different collections in here, but I think they did put in a lot of the ones that don't really sell that much. There was quite a few of the sports collections in there. I didn't use this on my hair because I wouldn't use it on my hair. I just had a feeling this would probably like dry me out, so I didn't bother. I used this on my body and it worked as a decent body wash. Would I buy it again? Absolutely not. I know with the types of body wash I want to use going forward, and it's just like a nice like fresh minty scent. Every now and again I might indulge in like something that's a bit more like fruity or like sweet or something else. Otherwise I'm just gonna go for like plain Jane shower washes, and Rituals products are not the cheapest, so yeah, this is a pass for me. Another sort of like interesting product is this Beauty Bay Hydrating Overnight Moisture Balm. This has hyaluronic acid and polyglutamic acid in here. I bought 2 of these and I think that's because they came as a duo. This is almost like you put on Vaseline on top of your skin. So I wouldn't just use this alone. It really does feel like a melted down Vaseline product. I would definitely say use another like moisturizer underneath this, but it was hydrating. It was good to use. I don't know if I would necessarily purchase this again when I can get almost the same thing from Vaseline, and that would be cheaper and it's much more long lasting. I have 1 more of these. I haven't even taken it out of my backup drawer yet because I have a lot of other like products that are open at the moment. But with literally autumn and winter coming up, I know my skin is going to be so much drier. I might as well like dig in that drawer a little bit, but I wouldn't like purchase this again. I do need to use the other one up very soon, because I don't actually remember when I bought this, which is the problem. The last skincare product is this Silka Fake Moisturizer by Aveen. This is such a fantastic moisturizer. I highly recommend. If you struggle with really dry skin, I feel like this product will be really, really good for you. When I had irritated my skin barrier and when I was getting like insane breakouts, I went ahead and purchased this, and honestly, this works like a charm. It took maybe 2 days and my skin was like feeling really good. And it's really just hydrating, like it really sinks into your skin. However, do not use this on wet skin, because if you do, you're going to be battling with it and you will never win. That is a losing battle and you will die on that hill. Not worth it. Definitely have to use this product when your skin is dry, but it's 100% like so worth it. I think one of the full size ones costs like £16, so it is a little bit pricey, but you can always get it on sale somewhere, I feel like. And with like the sales coming up anyway in the next sort of like month or two, you can definitely pick it up. With the winter months, like the really cooler months coming up anyway, this will definitely be like coming back into my everyday rotation to use as like a nighttime moisturizer, because this is so good. One of the things that sort of really sold me on this moisturizer was people who, this is like recommended. I don't know if it's necessarily recommended, but it's used by people who've got burns on the skin, as well as like people who've got cancer. So I'm assuming when they said that, they meant like people who might be undergoing treatment. That's what it said on the website. And it is definitely like a really gentle moisturizer, but it's really hydrating at the same time. And I think it's a really good thing. I would really recommend this. I have used up 2 perfumes this month, and I'm generally quite surprised I was even able to do that, considering I don't have the best of luck when it comes to using up things, and also because a lot of my sort of older perfumes have started to expire, which is really frustrating. But I did manage to use up this one from Marc Jacobs. This is the White Flower by Daisy. I know that's not the actual name, but that's the one that I used up. I don't remember how old this is, and I think this is about 4 years old, if not older. So I have definitely had this in my collection for quite a long time. The only issue I have is a lot of my really old ones are starting to expire, and it's starting to get a little bit frustrating. So at the moment, I'm sort of like project planning my perfumes, and I'm posting my project, my perfume project plan over on TikTok. So please make sure you check me out over there. It's Daily With Dills as well. And this was one of the ones I wanted to focus in on this month. And I'm so glad I use this up. Most of the times I would like, whenever I'd get ready, I would go ahead and use this. Every now and again, I would spray it in my room once I had like a clean room, just to kind of like try to use up this perfume. I also didn't feel like it was very long lasting either, but I'm just glad that this is now done. I wouldn't really go ahead and repurchase this as well. Like, I don't think it's one of those scents I'll necessarily miss in my collection. I am also trying to just like slowly decrease how much I have. I think when I first started the project plan, I had about 50 perfumes. And I'm down to like 47 now, I think. But I don't, that doesn't mean it's 47 full size perfumes. There's a lot of samples that make up that number. So I've just been like trying to use them all up. I sort of have a goal of, by the end of the year, I want to just have like about 40, if not less, preferably a lot less than that, perfumes. And then sort of make my way through and only repurchase perfumes that I genuinely really love. Because perfumes can be long lasting and they do take a long time to use up, and I don't really see myself becoming like a perfume collector. Like, I think that's great if you do, but the fact that so many of these have expired, I just don't really feel like I'll be going ahead and purchasing like so many perfumes. So I'm sticking to my goal of using them up. I'm gonna be eventually doing an update for my project plan over on TikTok very soon. So I'm going to be rolling in another perfume, but let's see. Another perfume I've used up is this Versace one, and I can't lie, I actually really enjoyed this. Of the two, I'll definitely repurchase this one. I think I've had this one for about 3-ish years, but I really like this scent. It's such an easy sort of like, you can just throw it on almost every day, and I really like that about this perfume. I think I got it on sale when I was like 50% off on like Superdrug, and I feel like this is one of those perfumes that's literally always being thrown on sale somewhere. So at the moment, I don't really feel like I need to repurchase another perfume, but eventually I will be picking this up again. I keep like an inventory of products I have in my perfumes, like skincare, haircare, makeup and stuff. So I have like categories for things that I would like to repurchase as well once I've used them up. And this is definitely one of them. It's just so I can sort of like remember the things I actually really enjoyed and decided that I want to like repurchase. But this is definitely one of them. I feel like it's such a nice, easy scent, and I love that about some perfumes. Like, sometimes all you need, like, you don't want to think about a perfume or like the vibe and if it fits sort of like the event or like the scene you're going to. And I feel like with this one and a few others I've used up, it's just so easy to just throw it on and you can be out the door. And I love that about this perfume. Okay. So the next lot of stuff is just makeup empties. Now, whenever there's even one makeup empty, I'm really happy because that just means things are sort of slowly moving out of my collection, which is great to see. The first empty I have is from Pink Honey and it's their brow glue. Now, you can't really tell as much, but I have used up as much as I can from this product. The rest of it became really difficult to use, and whenever I did use it, it would just make my brows really weird and it would leave like a weird residue on them. So I'm calling this an empty, like it's fine, I've used it up. The rest of it is this, I can't bother to deal with the hassle of it. I am no longer supporting Pink Honey and I haven't supported them for some time. I refuse to support and give money to brands that are racist or have a sort of track record of being racist or not being inclusive enough, especially if you are a brand in the West, because this is your market and it just doesn't make any sense to me when you do that. There's also like so many controversies around the brand owner and I'd rather not support them when there's other makeup brands out there that I can go ahead and like support instead that maybe have better morals or like, you know, just that whole thing. So that's like the last Pink Honey product I had and I will not really be showcasing them again on my channel or anywhere else unless they have like a really drastic change, which I highly doubt, but let's see. Another product I used up was this Stay All Night Blue Light Micro Setting Mist from e.l.f. Now this is quite clearly a dupe of the Urban Decay product. They've changed the packaging of this by the time when I bought this last year and I think they've changed the packaging again. They seem to do that quite often. This is a nice mattifying setting spray and it sort of did help keep my makeup locked in. I do like the e.l.f. setting sprays. One, they're really affordable. Two, they actually do work really, really well. And I really like this product. I will definitely be picking up a load more of setting sprays because I'm down to my last two. I have one that's supposed to be a mattifying spray and one that is like the Iconic London, like sort of glowy, dewy spray. Those are the only ones I have left. And I need to like sort of stock up again because I do get through setting sprays quite quickly because I use it whenever I'm like in between like layers. Also whenever I'm doing like eyeshadows, especially when I've got like shimmers, to sort of like make the shimmers pop, I spray a bit of setting spray on the brush. So yeah, I do tend to get through these quite quickly. So really like this product, probably will repurchase them. Oh, I forgot to mention I had one other perfume empty. This is the Prada Paradox perfume sample. I got this as a free gift for purchase when I bought, I think it was when I bought my Prada like little card holder. I actually really like this perfume and I can definitely see myself picking up the full size version of this because this is quite nice, but again I don't need any other perfumes just yet, but this is definitely on the wish list. I have a foundation empty for this month as well, which I think was crazy. This is the Rimmel Kind and Free foundation. I actually did really like this and the formula was really good. This is like a very light sort of almost medium coverage, but on like the lighter side of the medium coverage, if that makes sense. This was a nice, very light foundation. It didn't really feel heavy at all and I like that about this. The formula of this was really, really good. I think maybe I bought the wrong shade, but I did buy the wrong shade for the concealer anyway. This was nice though. This is supposed to be like a skin tint. Would I recommend this? Yes, if you don't have many companies around you that sort of do this type of product, because it was really, really good. I would like to try this again and see how it goes, but this was really, really good. I have way too many foundations for me to repurchase this at the moment, but I'm just glad that this is done. I don't know. I would definitely repurchase this in the future. I don't know if they do a shade that sort of matches me a little bit better than this. This is a shade 160 Vanilla. I used up a mascara and that means I'm down to my last mascara in my entire collection, which is crazy to me. This is the Beauty Bay High Key Mascara. This is actually really good and it surprised me when I used it. I use it so much and I would definitely pick this up again. It's only £12 and Beauty Bay always has some sort of a sale on. So if it's not 10%, it might be 20% off. So yeah, I would highly recommend this mascara. It wasn't bad and it was easy to remove as well. I liked that it actually lifted my lashes up because my lashes grow sort of straight, but like they go down almost and it sort of stays down. So it's hard for me to find mascaras that actually like show that I have lashes or even I've used mascara. So yeah, I actually really like this and it wasn't like clumpy at all either. And it's really affordable. So yeah, I'm literally down to my last mascara now. It's the one by Made by Mitchell. And now I need to find some new mascaras to buy. So there's two categories of makeup that I'm almost completely out of, and that's my setting sprays and my mascaras, which is crazy thinking. At one point I used to have like, I think at one point I had 30 mascaras or something stupid. I have two lip products that I managed to somehow use up. One of them is the Revolution Nightmare Before Christmas in the shade, I think this is Sally. This is like a really nice pink glowy sort of gloss. I don't know why I struggled to say that. This is a nice formula, I did like it. But again, I just have this issue with like a dry gloss brush. It just, I don't know what it is, but the texture of that just makes me physically sick. So I took the stopper out, and obviously, as you know, when you do that, it's not an ideal situation because it means that the product is gonna get messy. So I used this up as like a lip balm when I was around the house. This is a nice product. Would I repurchase this again? Maybe. But I don't know if I'm gonna keep this now or maybe just like recycle it, because I do love Nightmare Before Christmas, but I've now used this up. So it just looks a bit silly having like an empty product. So let's see what I do, but it was good. And I did actually quite like this collection that Revolution did. I think that discontinued very, very quickly because it sold out super quick. But it was a nice product. I have so many other lip glosses and just lip products in general that I'm really trying to just like push myself to use as many of those as I can. So let's see, my goal by the end of the year now is to use up maybe 10 lip products. And that's like a mix of like lip liners, lipsticks, lip balms, just and lip glosses, and just whatever else I can. So the last empty I have for this month is this Attitude Cosmetics lip oil. This is one of my favorite formulas. It's such a lightweight lip oil. It does feel hydrating, it smells really good, and it feels like a lip oil should feel like. It's not like thick and it's not sticky and gloopy, which is the one thing I absolutely hate. I really like the six purple six that she did. She's now released a whole bunch of new lip oils in different flavors, which I can't wait to try out. I have two more of those left. I don't know if I'm gonna sort of like push myself through and try to finish them up, because I feel like I do fly through them fairly quickly. So if I wanted to, I could possibly use it up in them like within a month. But I am trying to use up some of my lip balms at the same time, so let's see how that goes. But that is literally all of my empties for this month. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I'm genuinely quite surprised, because at one point I thought I'd only have maybe two empties at the max, but I still managed to pull through and work on some products. I will say though, however, I don't think for next month it's going to be looking too great, but I am still going to try. I do need to sort of like get back into my skincare again, because I feel like I've slightly fallen off a little bit, which is not an ideal situation to be in, because I really need to use up my skincare. But yeah, I'm also, like I mentioned, doing some other project plans on my TikTok. So at the moment there's only two. It's a perfume project plan and makeup, like a rolling project plan there as well. I will eventually do my skincare and hair care project plans over on TikTok too. So if you are interested, please make sure you follow me over there. It's Daily with Dills as well. That is all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed that, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.